Quarantine turned me into a plant lady. I went from having roughly 6 plants to 42 plants. But I just keep buying them, propagating them, trading them with friends, and I love it. I just love it. I love plants now. Hello and welcome back to my channel. I'm Megan. I share stylish, sustainable living tips, including home decor, DIY, vegan recipes, and life with plants. So I don't know about anyone else, but quarantine has totally changed me, changed my interests, changed my life, and I think it's true for so many people. So comment below on what kind of changes you've been experiencing during your day-to-day life in quarantine. For me, I have the newfound hobby of being a plant parent. As I've mentioned in a previous video, when we moved here, our apartment was really kind of like a blank slate. There wasn't a lot of decor items, there wasn't a lot of kind of like homey things. And so instead of, you know, buying expensive art and decorating with art and stuff like that, I decided to start decorating with plants. Germans love houseplants. You'll just walk on the street and in nearly every window, you'll see plants in them. And even during quarantine, plant shops and like flower shops were considered essential businesses. Germans think this is not very German. They're like, oh yes, normal. And I'm like, yeah, I mean, it is normal here, but it's so much different than what I witnessed in Chicago. I don't think I saw nearly as many people with houseplants in their windows. I think there's two big reasons why quarantine turned me into a plant lady. The first big reason is my anxiety about just the situation, my uncertainty, this kind of just general worry and stress was manifesting itself in this urge to consume. We live in this capitalist society where we're taught we have to consume and it's gonna make us feel better, and it's ingrained in us in this way we don't even understand, and that's definitely how it was coming out. I just was constantly feeling like I wanna online shop, I wanna buy things, but I also have this kind of like ethical mindset where I'm like, no, I really need to be more sustainable in the way that I live my life, and I can't just go around consuming, consuming, consuming. It just felt like a more ethical and sustainable way to indulge that urge to consume that I just couldn't shake. I just kept feeling it, and I needed an outlet, and plants became one of those outlets. And the second big reason why I think quarantine turned me into a plant lady is because I wanted to surround myself with life when I couldn't surround myself with human life. It was a way for me to just kind of get out this extroverted energy that I would normally be able to kind of express with other people, going out and getting coffee with friends, etc. And my plants became sort of an outlet for that. I could give them attention, I could check on them every day, I could see how they were growing, what they needed, make sure they were getting watered properly, fertilized properly. And as I acquired more plants over the course of quarantine, I started to realize that I got a lot of satisfaction out of watching them grow. When you could see the plant growing and doing really well, it was like, I helped it do that. I mean, it's doing it on its own, but I'm also part of that. It's also been really fun to like learn about what different plant species need and what conditions they do best under. I like to move my plants around to different parts of my house until I can like find the spot where they do the best. And now I have a ton of different species. I've learned a lot about how different types of plants do. I've learned a lot about how to propagate them and how to care for them best, where best they fit, what kind of environment they need. And I've also learned about a whole new community of people on social media who have a ton of knowledge to share about how to best raise plants, how to best live with houseplants. And it's a really fun hobby in that sense because there's sort of like an endless pool of knowledge that I can draw from and learn from. I don't think this hobby is going anywhere. I think this is very much here to stay. And who knows, maybe one day I'll be living in a greenhouse or have a giant garden and be growing all my own food. I don't know how this hobby will continue to develop, but I am here for it. So if there's one thing I can be grateful for out of this coronavirus time and this lockdown and all of this loneliness that we've been all forced to endure, it is that I'm surrounded by plants and life, and this is really, truly an unexpected surprise from this time. So I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching. Again, comment below if you have your own quarantine hobbies or habits that you have picked up. I'm so curious to hear how other people have been dealing with this time in lockdown. Thanks, everybody!